welcome to the House of Prayer Radio Ministries. You've got the woman behind the scenes today, Sister Angie Grizzle. Stay tuned, and coming up, Evangelist Willie Grizzle is going to wake your soul. So stay tuned, and God bless.
Amen, amen. Guess what? It's me again, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, back here on Splendor. Amen. Praise God. It's good to see you back here, back away from the camera. Amen. I know everybody on Facebook was getting tired of seeing my ugly mug, so let's just hear the voice, what the Lord have to speak today. Praise God. Today is about cleanliness. Amen. Praise God. Do you know how to be clean inside and out? Praise God. You know, there's a lot of drugs out there in this world today. There's a lot of pills. There's a lot of medicine that makes you feel good. Praise God. But you know, feeling good is not being good. Praise God. See, my friends, today is the day that God has made us to be cleansed by His Spirit, His Holy Ghost, but most of all, the power and authority of His love. Amen. So, my friends and family, as we grab another song here from Brother Steve Warren, praise God. Let's get that Holy Ghost preacher filled on fire and let Him ring your soul today.
People say I'm no good and crazy as a loon. I praise Him in the morning and I praise Him in the afternoon. Kinda like the saints of old, I love to trust Him and obey. I don't have to worry, cause I fall on my knees and pray. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing when I can get it from God's throne. Yeah, I can. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. You see the preacher man talking on the TV, and he's trying to guide my soul. Tells me to hold to a promise, trust Jesus and don't let go. You see Jesus walked on the water, and I know that is true. Next time you see Him come a walking, He'll be walking on the clouds for you. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing, oh, and I can get it from God's throne. Oh yeah. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. Another drink of wine, and a blind man wants to see. But Jesus died on a rugged old cross to set all four men free. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing when I can get it from God's throne. Yeah, I can. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. Holy Ghost filled preacher alone. Yeah, that's the way I see.
and amen. Amen. Just leave this Holy Ghost-filled preacher alone. Amen. That's here at the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. That's what we're filled with, the Holy Ghost. We're here to help someone in a walk of life that's been tore down, broken up, and feels like the world's give up on them. But my friend, my Lord has not give up on you. Praise God, He is seeking out the ones that are seeking Him. Amen. Seeking the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness. Praise God. Today is the day of salvation, my friend. Don't you know that you can make a choice to cleanse the heart from all wickedry, all pain and suffering? Praise God. So, my friends and family, today, let's go to prayer. If you got a prayer, hey, hit me up at brothergrizzle76@gmail.com, and we will pray for you diligently. We'll put it here in the chat room. brothergrizzle76@gmail.com. Amen. You can hit that email there, or you can hit us up on Facebook under Evangelist Willie Grizzle. Praise God. We would love to hear from you. And if you'd like to call and give your testimony or a prayer, amen. Praise God. Remember, you got 3 minutes, praise God. And if you got a sermon, praise God, and you feel led by the Lord to use this platform here to bring a word, praise God, send it. Let's hear it. Let's enhance the kingdom of God. Amen. Let's bring the word of Jesus Christ to a lost and dying nation, because think about it, my friend. There are so many people out there that needs to hear your story. Praise God. And see, to show that you have overcome. Praise God. That you stand in the gap for Jesus Christ. Praise God. See, that's what we need to be doing. Don't be worrying about what everybody else has got. You need to be worrying about what you're doing for the kingdom of God. And see if you're ready to be with Him forevermore in that glorious land we call heaven. Amen. That place where Jesus has gone to prepare a place for us. Praise God. See, my friends, that's what we need to be seeking tonight, is seeking for that heavenly home. Praise God. But we got to get some things worked out in our life, don't we? We got to get the sin under the blood. We need to be changed. We need to cleanse the heart. Praise God. We're going to be in Proverbs 16 tonight. So, my friends, after this testimony here from Brother Steve, amen, my former pastor, praise God, he called in, and let's see what the brother's got to say. Amen.
Hello, Brother Willie. We love you. God bless you.
My bad. That's Brother Boyd, but let's listen in anyways.
This is Brother Boyd Blended in Idaho. I wanted to call in here. I'm a little bit sad. I emailed you over on Facebook. Sister Louise, her husband Greg's been fighting for his life, and they say that his kidneys have stopped working. I had an email here today from Sister Louise, and let's be keeping all them in prayers. She's a great sister. They've got the Bibles around the world ministry, and that's too bad that her husband Greg started having all those problems with his liver and everything else there. So we've been praying for him, and we'll keep him in prayers. And let Brother Eddie, his court thing going on today, I haven't heard what happened with that yet. So let's keep all of us in prayers, and we love you, and thank you for praying for myself here, for my mom, my sister Ann, and all of us, my fiancée Edna and her daughter Isabel. It's been snowing here. We've actually got some snow now, and I'm going to have to go out and do a bunch of shoveling today, so may the Lord keep me safe. I'm going to have to go out and do a bunch of snow shoveling here. It's going to be a busy day, so I thank the Lord for helping all of us today. Father, I want to come to you in prayer right now in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. I'm feeling sad right now about Sister Louise and her husband Greg there. I pray and ask that you could please work a miracle and touch Greg and heal Greg and heal his body, his liver, his kidneys, and everything there, Father. Just please work a miracle in that situation. We pray for your will to be done, and please comfort and help Sister Louise there. She's a great sister, and please help her with all that she's going through today. Hebrews 13:6, Lord is my helper. Philippians 4:13, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Please give Greg, Sister Louise, all of them their strength to make it through the day today and help them, may your will be done. We do pray and ask that you can work a miracle in Greg in the name of Jesus, so he can testify to the world how you've healed him and helped him. We want to pray for all of us today, Father, for you to heal and help us. We want to pray for our brother evangelist, Willie Grizzle. We love him a lot. Please help him with all that he's doing. Help him with the ministry there. Help him with his job, work, with everything he's doing. Give him strength. I know he needs strength to make it through each day. Philippians 4:13. Give Brother Willie strength. Touch and heal his wife, Angie, his daughter, Holly, and all of them there. We love them a lot. Please touch and heal myself here in every way. And my mom, Jerry, her heart, lungs, kidneys and arthritis. My sister, Ann, and her cirrhosis of the liver. Please keep us all safe here. I got to go out and shovel snow today and do some different stuff here. Just keep us all safe here. And anyone hearing this, please keep us all safe. We want to for you touch and heal my fiance, Edna, her daughter, Isabel, over in the Philippines, and heal Edna's panic attacks. We want to pray and ask for anyone hearing this prayer for them to realize that they have hope through your son, Jesus. Jesus Christ, your son died on the cross for our sins, and we can turn our hearts and lives over to Jesus at any time. Our sins can be forgiven. We can repent and go to heaven. And please help people to be healed from sin and sickness and disease and turn their hearts and lives over to your son, Jesus. Today, and we thank you in the name of your son, Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Brother Boyd from out of Idaho. Amen. Praise God. So let's go to prayer right now for Sister Texas and her husband. You know, it's awful hard, praise God, to see when you have to give up your spouse, the one you love, the ones that that you treasure so much, praise God. But you know, God has a purpose and a plan. When our job on this earth is over, if we're right with God and we're in the presence of the whole mighty Jesus Christ, praise God, I'm telling you, there ain't nothing like that. There ain't nothing to be in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. So everybody right now, old-fashioned prayer the Lord gave me right now, and that's to pray right now. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. On earth as is in heaven, give us our daily bread. Forgive us of our debts, and also we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So my friends and family, tonight we're going to be in the book of Proverbs. Praise God, Proverbs. You got your Bibles, you got your apps, wherever, how you read the Word of God, I'll be reading from the King James Version. Praise God. And as we get our heart warmed with Jesus Christ, we need to think about the prayers of the righteous. See, God don't want to use somebody that ain't real with Him. Amen. Everybody thinks that we got to do it a certain way the preacher does it, or a certain way a church does it. But God says do it His way. Praise God. Starting in the 16th verse in Proverbs, it says this: thou preparedness of thy heart and man, and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. Praise God. And it says all the ways of man are cleaned in his own eyes, but the Lord's weight in spirit. Praise God. Let's stop there for just a moment. Now we see, Sister Angie, you know, we see that we got to do it certain ways and certain times, don't we? Mm-hmm. Praise God. But you know, God says that He does it through the spirit and the weights of our faithfulness. Amen. Praise God. And you know, like it says in that first verse, prepare of the heart on in men. He didn't say prepare your outfit. He didn't say wear your suit and tie. He said prepare the heart. He wants to work on the inside of you, my friend. He wants you to be cleansed where the motor ticks, where the motor runs in your life. Praise God. And a lot of people don't want that motor to be ran clean. What they want to do, they want to soup it up. They want to be recognized and known for their deeds. My friend, God is not looking for your good deeds. He's looking for the faithful. He's looking for the ones that has made yourself ready and ready to come to the kingdom of God. Praise God. In the third verse, it says, commit thou works unto the Lord, and thou shalt be established. See, He ain't just saying what you go, like me, I work in a soap factory. Amen. from 12 hours a day, 12 hours every other day. Praise God. And when we're working, we will be working with Jesus. Amen. When we see somebody that's broken or sick or tore down, that we both to be able to put out a branch hand, amen, a branch hand that talk to them and ask them if we could pray with them. Praise God that they can come to the centerfold and get cleansed by the grace and the mercy of God. See, my friend, you know, there's a lot of times that we keep our mouth shut when we should be opening it. Amen. We should be, every time that we get out, we should be praying for somebody. Because, you know, this walk of life, we're going to end up paying one day if we're wrong with God. And if we think, well, I got it made. I don't need no man. I don't need no woman. I don't need no prayers. I can make it all by my own. No, my friend, you cannot. Because tonight is going to be something brought to you that you need a cleansed heart. You need to get out of yourself and get in Jesus. Amen. And it says here in the fourth verse, the Lord have made all things for himself. Praise God. Ye, even the wicked, in the day of evil. Praise God. You know, a lot of people kind of miss that, don't they? They think, well, the devil is the one who creates all evil. No, God send the wicked where they can be changed by his grace and his mercy. Praise God. See, if everything was good, you would know evil, would you? See, my friend, that's why the devil wants you to blame God for everything. Amen, praise God. But you know, God is telling us right there in that scripture, commit thou works unto the Lord, and through you shall be established. Praise God. How do you establish yourself? You get a footing in the Word of God. You listen, you read, you pray, you meditate on the Word of God. You read for what it says, not what everybody else says. Amen. Praise God. In that fifth verse, it says, to everyone proud in their heart is abomination unto the Lord. And thou hast joint in hand, and he shall not unpunished. See, a lot of people today thinks that, well, we got to be under some big fancy church or some fancy teacher. No, my friend, I was saved by the grace and mercy of my Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. You know, today I got my license papers where I can go into the prisons and I can go into places where you have to have the law of the land rules here. Praise God. And you know, a lot of people, I've noticed a brother today, he is already criticizing me about it. Well, who's the church? Who's doing this? Who's doing that? I'll tell you who's doing it. And that's Jesus Christ. My Lord told me to do it where I can get out and where more people can hear the Word of God. Where people could trust in Jesus Christ and His glory. See, my friend, that's the problem with a lot of people today. They have forgotten that we got a job to do as evangelists, as a bishop, as an apostle, as a prophet. We all have a job to do. If we're not doing that job, well, if you don't do your job, what happens, sister? If you don't do your job, you lose your job, don't you? See, that's the problem with a lot of people. People think, well, there's that preacher. He's born sitting on that corner. He's making all this money, and he's doing this, and he's doing that. Well, my friend, if he's doing that there for getting his own greed, getting his own power, getting his own thing, I'm telling you what's going to happen. He's already got his reward, and there is no reward for him in heaven. See, my friend, we got to understand that God gives his rewards in secret in times of prayer. When you closed yourself off to this world, and it's just you and the Lord and that Holy Ghost is staring upon you. See, my friend, that's when you notice that God is in the midst, that God has given you a blessing to be in his presence. Praise God. See, my friends, too many times we don't want to cleanse our hearts. We don't want to pray like the righteous way that you're supposed to be, not just the way people tell you to be. Praise God. See, my friends, each and every day of my life, I tell myself, Lord, if there's any darkness upon me, cleanse it. Lord, if there's any darkness around me, get it away. Lord, cripple them. Put them under your feet, Lord, where I can rise up and be in you, Jesus. You don't understand what I'm saying today? Too many people today have forgotten that God is still the King and the Lord of Lords. Praise God. In the sixth verse, it says here, by the mercy and the truth of equities is purged. Do you understand what it means? That all your equities and all these things that you sweet talk people to get something. Praise God. And boy, I put on a good show. And I heard, boy, I got people screaming and hollering. They're throwing money at me. Well, praise God. This is the will of God. That is a lie from the pit of hell. I'll tell you what the will of God is, being faithful and true. When he speaks, you speak. But when he tells you, shut your mouth, but put that bottom lip on top of that other lip and just shut it, that's when you need to listen closely what the Lord is telling you to do. Praise God. But I want you to read on there for a second. And he says, by the fear of the Lord, may depart from evil. Praise God. If we purge ourselves from our sins and our wicked ways, we come to the truth and the reality of God. See, my friend, we don't want to go out and watch them old filthy movies. We don't want to turn on the TV and somebody bashing God. We don't want none of that. We want the pureness. We want the grace and the mercy of God to walk in our lives. We want to be in that light where no darkness is. See, my friend, too many times, too many people live in that darkness. They want to go out and do their thing. They want to, I'm going to build me a kingdom upon this earth. I don't need God. I just do what I want. Let me have all the bank accounts. Let me set up millions of churches and they come worship me. My friend, if you got that kind of spirit, well, let me tell you, it's not of God. See, God is going to destroy everything that you got in your house. Everything that you have upon this world will be gone one day. And the only thing that God is going to get of you is your soul. Is your soul cleansed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ? Have you walked the walk? Have you talked the talk? Praise God. You know, May the 27th, 2015, I got registered to be a minister. Praise God, but I've been preaching ever since since 2008. But you know, I had to take a time. I had to study under a man of God. I had to listen to the man of God. See, my friends, I listened to a lot of teachers, but I might not agree with all of them because the way they're teaching, how they give their filth out. Do you hear what I'm saying? How many times, Sister Angie, have you seen somebody that dressed up and had all kinds of money, had all kinds of things, and the way they presented themselves, way they come out, and they come out as hateful and negativity? Praise God. How many times have you seen that, Sister Angie?
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. See, my friend, if you come in as a bobcat, you people ain't going to come pet a bobcat. They're not going to stand around a bobcat. If you come at it as a stinking skunk, they're going to get away from that stinking skunk. You hear what I'm saying? See, my friend, God wants you to get mercy. He wants you to get love. But my sin, my friend, if you live in sin, you die within, you will see hell. You will rise your eyes up. Praise God. See, my friends, today we got to understand that God wants us to give all our heart, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Not just one on Sunday. Not just when you go into Bible school. Not just when you're going to get your ears tickled. God wants you to be delivered. And how do you get delivered? You got to be cleansed. You got to take that antivirus of the Holy Ghost. That's right. You got to get that old heart changed. It's got to be broken. It's got to be took down. It's got to be wiped clean. See, my friend, too many times we want to clean ourselves off and put a dirty suit on, but we walk in filth. I'm talking about your heart. Praise God, because if you ain't got a broken heart for the lost, my friend, you got a problem. Because, well, I don't want to see nobody go to hell. What about you, Sister Angie? Do you want to see anybody go to hell? You would do it, and you're like me. You would want to do everything in your power to keep somebody from walking right into hell. See, that's the problem with a lot of church today. They want you to come to their church. They want you to go to them. My friends, whatever happened about doing what the Word of God says, go out and preach the gospel to all creation. He didn't say huddle up in a house. He didn't say sing kumbaya around a campfire. No, he said go out. Be out and encourage them. Come into the house of God and be worshiping and praising Him. Praise God, but that's not that going on anymore. What it is, come to my services and you'll be blessed. What about being blessed right where they're at? Now, come on. Let's be honest. Let's metal hit the road here. Whatever happened about having church right where you're at? Whatever happened about you raising Jesus' name up instead of your own? You know, praise God, I hear this all the time. This ministry is doing this. This ministry is doing that. Well, let me ask you, the ones out there that I'm going to make you mad. Yeah, I'm ready. I already see it in the spirit. There's going to be coming up people knocking on my door. Well, I need to talk to you. Well, you know, go ahead. I've heard this dog and pony show before. And I'm going to tell you this. If you can't serve God on the outside, away from all your party cliques, you can't serve God in the house of God. And as my friends, I'm telling you, you need to repent before you perish. You need to cleanse your heart, your mind, and your soul and spirit. Praise God. In the seventh verse, it says, when a man ways please the Lord, it makes his enemies to be at peace with him. Praise God. Now, this with a carnal mind, that don't make sense, does it, Sister Ann? How could your enemy have peace with you unless God puts peace in their heart? Praise God. How many in the chat room? Well, I ain't got nobody in here. I guess I've already made half of them mad or they don't even care. But either way, the gospel's going to go out. How many times have you seen people that you tried to see somebody preach the gospel and you tried to see somebody do a good thing and they wanted to say, where's your credentials? Where's this? Where's that? Why you question God's people? Why do you have to make up fairy tale stories or you have to openly shame somebody? Because you want to feel big? You want to feel bad? Well, let me tell you, you're going to be feeling big and bad in hell. When you rise your eyes and look at the devil and he says, I got you. Well, I went to church. I know Jesus Christ. Yeah, you know him, but you didn't have him. My friend, you got to understand, you just once saved, always saved nonsense the world's peddling out today is from the gates of hell. And they're churning out all these antichrist spirits out and trying to churn and twist God's word. My friends, going to church don't save you. Being in a clique don't save you. Even the water that God has created does not save you. Only Jesus Christ can save your soul. See, my friends, you got to cleanse the heart, the mind, and the spirit if you want peace. My friend, like it says there in the seventh verse, when a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies be at peace with him. Come on now. Praise God. Now think about that for just a moment. Why would God bring you happiness or bring you peace? Because why? You're faithful to Him. You love Him. And you understand His whole understanding what He have you to do. But my friend, if you have to have drama in your life, you have to have nitpicking everything in your life, well, it's got to be this way or it's no way. My friend, I'm the only one going to heaven. Well, my friend, you might be on your free ticket to hell. See, my friend, this is what you got to understand. We got to show the righteousness of God. We got to show the light that beams in our hearts. We got to show these people out in this world today that God is not dead. He is very much alive, my friend, because God wants us to be saved, sealed, and sanctified. Praise God. Now look over here in the 8th verse, and it says, better is a little with righteousness and a great revenge without rights. Amen. Praise God. You know how many people today that don't want to try to be good? I mean, how many times have you stopped and thought when somebody's cussing you out that you react ungodly? that you first thing you want to do is you want to throw them arms up and fight. Boy, you get in that flesh and I'm going to beat this man down. I'm going to smack this kid. Boy, I'm just going to whip a dog far out of him. See, is that godly? No, that's not godly. See, God wants us to be healed. But we got to be cleansed. We got to have a clean slate in our life. We got to come before Him in His grace and mercy. See, that's the problem with the church, the people that go to church. They think, well, the pastor is going to carry me to heaven. My bishop, my teacher is going to carry me into heaven. Well, my friend, we're all going to face judgment. We're all going to bow before God. And we're going to answer for our deeds. Look here over here in the 9th verse. A man's heart devises his ways, but the Lord directs his steps. You know, we think about doing things. We think about how we want to do it. But is God directing your path? Are you going where He tells you to go? Or are you just going where you want to go? You want to do your thing. You want to be in the clique. You want to everybody, oh, kiss my ring because I'm a bishop. Or pat me because I'm a prophet. Pat me because I'm an evangelist. No, my friend, if you go to places where you're liked, you're not truly serving God. See, my friends, you go where you not, no one knows you. You go into these alcoholic houses, these crack houses. You go into these whore houses, and you go shining your light of Jesus Christ. You go tell them the truth, because if you don't tell the truth and you get caught in a lie, what does the Bible say, Sister Andy? Where all liars go? They all go to hell. See, my friend, that's what the problem with the world today. They think they can put on a good little servant. They think we can run each other down. Oh, man, I don't like what you said about me. I don't care what you think about me. I care about what God is doing with me. Praise God. You know, I sit here and I just think about what all people has done to me. How they have questioned God's will in my life. And you know, my friends, there's going to be a day that the Word of God says this, that the saints will judge the angels and the unjust. Praise God, and you know I work every day in the Spirit to be that saint, to be the one to just judge the unjust in this world. Praise God, because that's an upgrade, my friend. It's an upgrade from living your life in sin, an alcohol state, an angry state, and a frustration state. See, my friend, frustration can lead you to sin. Oh, no, no, frustration just means you're upset and all. Frustration, that means that your mind is took off of God. You're doing it in the flesh. See, frustration is what cripples people. They don't understand that God has a plan. But, my friend, you can't just kick up tires when somebody steps on your toes. See, my friends, that's why we got to come to the truth of understanding of Jesus Christ. We got to come to the will and the power and authority of God. See, my friend, like we listen to Brother Steve today. Praise God, he's given the Word of God. He's taken 3 minutes out today to call that number, 1-270-681-8098, and give his testimony. Now this man, I know, I walked with this man. Now we might have disagreement how we handle ourselves around women. I believe you treat women just like queens. I believe you treat them with respect. I treat each and every woman, doesn't matter if they cussing, calling me all kinds of names, I treat them with like they're a queen. Because there's a reason why God has put them in my life. But you know, sometimes them queens is a stooge. It's the truth. Now, you can ask my wife right now if she would admit it, how many times I've been towards a woman and they treated me like a dog. Yeah. And I was sweet and I was doing my best to keep in the hands of God and to help them out in every fashion and form. And they turn around and render me evil. Yeah. But did I get mad?
No.
What did I do? I went to prayer. I seek God about it, and He says, give them to me, and I'll deal with it. Praise God. See, my friend, we got to understand that when we're in this valley, when people criticize us, and they put us down, they think, well, you're just gonna have to be my friend. You're gonna have to put Jesus to the side, cause I'm me. That's right. You are you. But what's in you is what I'm looking for. Is it got? Do you have a clean heart, a mind, soul, and spirit, or are you just playing church? Are you just playing to get by? My friend, I don't play church. I live with the church. When I walk down the street, when I'm at work, or if I'm at a gas station, God's right there with me. You know, I slip and I fall. I get upset. But praise God, God says He is always there. He knows that we're going to have bad days. He knows that we're going to be tore up. He knows that we're going to be so mad at the world. He's mad at the world too. Think about it. What does it say in the book of Genesis? That God looked upon the earth and He couldn't find one righteous man. Except for who? Noah. He was a just man. Praise God. See, my friend, think about that. God had all this creation. I mean, all these people. And He can only find one person that was righteous and just. Praise God. Now, He didn't say His family was righteous and just, but God said He saved them, didn't He? All together, there was 8 of them. He didn't say His kids, His boys were great. He didn't say His boys even know God. See, my friends, we got to understand today that God makes a way for each and every one of us. Praise God. Let's look in here in 11th verse. A just weight and balance are the Lord's, and all weights of bags are His works. Now, my friends, if God has blessed you to preach, if God has blessed you to sing, God has given you the blessings to cook, wash clothes, whatever it is, you give it to God and give Him the praises. Praise God. You know, I praise God each and every day that I get to wake up and just one more day to praise and worship His holy name. You know, praise God, there's a lot of times that I don't feel like even getting out of bed. There's a lot of times that I hurt so bad that it's, well, Lord, just kill me. You know, praise God. But you know, God says, no, you're not done yet. You got to get out here and you got to help somebody else that's broken in sin, that needs to come to the righteous and get their healing on. Praise God. And you're probably thinking, there's a, well, if you hurt so bad, why God hadn't healed you? Well, let me ask you this. Why God didn't heal Paul? Why didn't God spare John the Baptist? Now think about this. We all got a job. He is testing me as much as He's testing you, my friend. Are you tested by Christ or are you being tested by the devil? Praise God. Now think about this. Let's go back to Job for a moment. Job, boy, he was blessed by God because he loved God. And he was faithful to God. Well, but the old devil come to, hey, take your hands up off old Job there and let's see, he'll shake his fist at you. And he says, all right, you can do anything you want to do, Job, but you can't kill him. Well, Job, boy, he lost all his family except his wife, lost all his crops, his houses fell in. Praise God. But you know, he didn't give up on God. And I always love I know it makes my wife mad, and I look at her funny when I say it. You know where it talks about a foolish woman. And he said, well, you know, his wife said to him, he said, you foolish. He said, how did he put it? And she said, won't you, God has gave up on you. Why don't you just die? He just looked at her and he said, oh, you speak as a foolish woman. Praise God. How many times that you been there, my friend, that you been in them old sores? I mean sin sores that you been so frustrated, angry, mad, and you just said, well, I'm just going to be mad. I'm going to do services about them and give them a guilt trip, and I'm going to talk about them and shame them and all that. My friend, this has happened every day. On Facebook, on her own spender, it's happened on YouTube. Everybody wants to shame everybody trying to make themselves be something they're not. See, God wants to heal you. God wants to deliver you, but you got to let him cleanse you. You got to let the work of God be seen, not of your works, but of his. Amen. Praise God. It is an abomination to the king to commit wickedness, for the throne is established by the righteousness. See, my friend, his throne is not made by wickedness. It's made by the righteous of the heart. That means there's got to be a cleansing. There's got to be a earth-changing thing in your life that you've got to have. Praise God. See, men, so many people today have forgotten that you got to be righteous with God. If you want to get with where Jesus is, he does listen to sinners, but he listens for that one reason. You know what? You know what one reason he listens for, Sister Angie? Yeah. That one reason is to hear you repent and ask for forgiveness. You know, everybody says, well, he's got a deaf ear on me, or he's not paying attention to me. I'll tell you this, he's listening to every word you're saying. What he wants to hear is say, Lord, forgive me. I repent of my ways. I turn away from my wickedness. Praise God. He didn't say, I enhance in my wickedness. He says, turn away from your wickedness. Praise God. And it says here, and the righteous lips are the delight of the king, and thou love him with speaking right. See, my friend, there's a way to speak right, and there's a way of speaking God's word with anger. Oh, God's going to burn you up. God's going to... My friend, if there's going to be any burning up, you're going to walk in hell. Now, he chastens the one he loves. Now, let me tell you that. I've took my beatings. I've walked away from God. I want to throw my hands up. I don't want to hear that. And God says, no, I ain't done with you yet. And everything I put my hands on, it broke. Even my marriage. Wife can testify to that. There was one time... For what, about 3 years, we lived in pure hell, didn't we? But God said, do you love her? And I said, yes, sir, I do. If you love her, love me first. And I started praying about that. And I says, Lord, I can't love her like that. And he says, do you love me? I said, yes, Lord, I do. Love me like you, what she needs to be loved. And I thought, my Lord, it's as simple as that. That if I just love you first, you'd give me the love to love her. And I'm glad to say that we're fixing to have what, our 18th? Yeah, 18th in September, if the Lord be it. Praise God. Been married 18 years. And like I said, if anybody says they've ever had a perfect marriage, they're a liar. Repent. Because it ain't easy putting up with me, isn't it? And it ain't been a picnic putting up with her. But anyways, but you know, we draw closer when we let God take a hold of it, don't we? See, this is the problem with a lot of people today. They don't want to get their hearts cleansed. They don't want to let God take over. I'm not talking about calling your best buddy preacher to pray for you. No, I'm talking about the King, the Creator of all things, the one that put life in us. Praise God. Reaching up for him where he can grab a hold of you. Praise God. See, that's the problem with a lot of church today. They won't grab a hold of God. What they'll do, they'll grab a hold of their imaginations. They want you to come into their church. They want you to sit under them. They want you to be their servant, be their slave. No, my friends, I'm a servant of Jesus Christ. And my Father is God. Because I confess Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. I believe that he died and resurrected again. I believe that he's coming back. See, my friends, we got to have this to know that God is coming. Each thing we do in this walk of life, we got to see where we stand with God. Are we going to be abomination unto God, be some kind of stink that he has to turn his head away from us and let us walk in, or do we cry out for the mercy of God and of His holiness? Do we just sit there and whine and complain about all these things of the world, or do we call upon the precious hands of Jesus Christ? Praise God. Let's look in here in the 13th verse, is the 14th verse. The wrath of the king is a messenger of death, but a wise man will purify it. See, my friend, a wise man seek the Lord Jesus Christ. A wise man grabs a hold of the hand of Jesus Christ each and every day of life. A fool sits there and makes fun, mockery of God. My friends, if you learned anything at all tonight, I want you to know this, that God, our Lord Jesus Christ, is calling for you. Now, I know somebody listening live or on archive right now says, well, you don't know where I've been. I don't have to know where you've been. God knows. You're probably thinking, well, I'm a pastor of a church that's got 20 people, and I can't confess, they'll turn me away. I'd rather let God forgive me and rebuild me than be a party pal in church. See, my friend, God wants you. He don't want your buildings. He don't want your close friendships. Hey, He don't even want your wife. He wants you to come in the Spirit of God. He wants you to come willingly to Him and open your heart, mind, body, soul, and spirit. So, my friends, that's what the Lord has given me to give to you. I'm going to play this song and a testimony, and we'll be back. Amen. Praise God. Keep on praying for us, because we sure need it. Amen.
Oh, a man from Galilee, he hung upon that cruel old tree. He was dying for sinners like me. And as the blood came dripping down from the cross onto the ground, there was one drop that He shed for me, just for me, and the sins of my soul, just to cleanse me, make me free, and make me whole. And as the blood came dripping down from the cross onto the ground, there was one drop that He shed for me. Well, they pierced Him in His side. Oh, forgive them, now He cried. I will pardon all the sins they commit. And as the blood and the water came, oh, glory to His precious name. And that one drop that He shed for me, just for me, and the sins of my soul, just to cleanse me, make me free, and make me whole. And as the blood came dripping down from the cross onto the ground, there was one drop that He shed for me. Oh, when in a better land, before the throne I stand, and its beauty I'm able to see, I want to look upon His face, I want to thank Him for His grace. And that one drop that He shed for me, just for me, and the sins of my soul. and make me whole. And as the blood came dripping down from the cross onto the ground, there was one drop that he shed for me. Oh, that one drop that he shed for me.
That boy was really hollering and anxious. That boy was sort of North London and Idaho. Good morning to Brother Eddie and Miss Pauline from Crossville, Tennessee. Good morning, Brother Joe Wallace from Crossville, Tennessee, his wife. Good morning, Brother Chris Cheney from Crossville, Tennessee. And good morning to Brother North London and Idaho, those that may be listening this morning. This is Brother Steve, 511 West Main Street here in Scottsdale, Kentucky, where we're experiencing another blue sky day, which the Lord has given to us to enjoy and to praise His name in. Got a piece of scripture here, Psalm 119, 7-12. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord. Teach me thy statutes without my lips. Have I declared the judgments of thy mouth? I have rejoiced in the way of the testimonies as much as in all riches. I meditate on thy precepts. And have respect unto thy ways. I will delight myself in thy statutes. I will not forget thy word. Praise the Lord. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Little David here in these few verses says, teach me. Teach him the statutes. Help him to think about His word. Help him to live by Jesus Christ. Help him to live by the word of God. And to apply to his life. May the Lord bless you and keep you, Brother Holly, Angie, Brother Eddie and Janie, and Brother Crossville, Tennessee, Miss Pauline. Brother Joe Wallace, and Brother Crossville, Tennessee, his wife, Michelle. And Brother Chris Cheney, and Brother Crossville, Tennessee, and Brother Boyd London, and that.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I found. chains are gone.
My friends, today I hope that you're blessed. Hello, Brother Philip. Good to see you in the chat room. I guess I still got one friend left. Amen. Praise God. But, you know, it's been an honor to serve God tonight and to get back on the speaker here and just serve Him. Amen. Everybody wants to be a king. I just want to be a servant. I just want to worship God in the spirit and truth. I just want to see people be real. You know, a lot of people, they put on a show. They put on a hallelujah, and then go home and cheat on their wife or even leave their wives. My friends, I want my wife, my right hand, to be with me at all times. Because, my friend, if you cut your hand off, it's no longer useful for you, is it? See, my friends, tonight is about getting your heart cleansed, getting right with God. My friend, because we're on borrowed time. At any moment, at any second, God say, you're done. And the truth is, there's two things He's going to say to you. Enter in or depart. There is no land nowhere that in the Bible that says that He'll give you time to repent after you're dead. Once you finish this life, my friend, it is over. See, my friend, you'll go to eternity somewheres. And I hope and I pray today that you come to the center of God's will. I pray that you will grab that loving arm of Jesus Christ. And you will follow Him to the very end. My friend, we're riding in this spiritual car with Jesus. Are you going to let Him drive, or are you going to try to fight the wheel with Him? My friends, God don't fight. God heals and He kills. And He wants to heal you tonight. If you're lost and undone, and you feel dirty, you feel like that there's no hope, that not the creator of all things can save your soul, my friend, you're lying to yourself. God says He would forgive you for everything except blasphemy against the Holy Ghost. It doesn't matter if you raped children, if you murdered babies, if you have run down and bashed everybody that you've ever seen. God said He'd forgive you if you believe and let Him cleanse you and put a new heart in you. See, my friend, it all begins with one word. Lord, forgive me. It's as simple as that. And believe it. See, my friend, you got to believe it. Without believing, there is no chance that you'll ever be able to walk with Jesus. So, my friends and family, I'm going to end this off with a prayer and a song. And we'll be back on in the morning, probably around about 7 o'clock. Remember me in prayer as I remember you. Remember, Jesus is the way. Lord of Heavenly Father, we ask you, Lord, the ones that go listens to this service today, Lord, live or archive, we ask you, Lord, to deal with their hearts and mind and spirits. We ask you, mighty God, that you stand right over them right now and just touch their hearts. Lord, let them be able to bend knee before you, Lord. And that, Lord, we ask you to put that repentance in their spirit. Lord, we ask you, mighty God, to let them cry out and ask forgiveness tonight. Lord, we all fall short, Lord, but Lord, we know that you're there to pick us back up. Lord, you says in your word, if we believe, we shall receive. Lord, I'm ready to receive that blessing that you've given us. By the works that you've done it already in this ministry, Lord, I see your power. And Lord, I thank you so much for the vision that you've given me to see what's real and what's pretend. We ask you, mighty God, to bless Brother Eddie tonight. Lord, we ask you, mighty God, do you bless Brother Chris Cheney? Bless all these ministers that are still on the battlefield, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, to strengthen us. Let us come together in one mind and one accord. Lord, you know we bump heads. You know there's hatred all around us, Lord. But you know, Lord, your will be done. It says very clearly that your word does not go void. So, Lord, I pray and I seek you tonight that let this word traveled all around the world. And every hill and holler, every heart, mind, and spirit, Lord, let them feel your presence and let your will be done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. Till probably about 7:30 in the morning. Remember, Jesus is the way.
blah, 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 blah. Oh, you teen outlaw, he'll be right there.